Kroger food. What? There's no way.
Oh, I'm going to go in my car and eat that shit. Shit more expensive than the movie. What's going on, Murphy?
Welcome back to our channel, guys.
If you are new, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Hit that button, turn that post notifications, and join the family. We're going to be teaching y'all how to steal today.
Ryan. So basically, we're having a little date night, but if y'all aren't sneaking stuff into the movies, what are y'all doing?
So this is what we got going on. We teaching y'all 101 how to sneak stuff in. Now, here's the thing. If you got a big tote bag like this,
anytime,
you're good, right? But if you think your movie theater is going to check it, oh, did we tell them we were going to the movies?
No.
So we're going to the movies. We're watching some movie that Montana found.
It's everywhere on TikTok. You already know.
What is it?
Sydney Sweeney.
What movie is it called?
Anybody But You. Anyone But You.
It's some romance shit.
Yeah. It's supposed to be like the best like rom-com out in a long time. So we ordered food.
We got Five Guys. Whole ass fries, meal. Two burgers, having a little cheat meal tonight. And the movie theater we going to don't serve real food, so.
And I'm telling you right now, all of this food that we have, like this is a whole meal, and it would have been double, triple the price of the movie theater.
So we're in this big ass tote bag. You already know they're gonna check this shit. Come on, now you got a whole damn restaurant in this thing, bruh.
Okay, now I need like
some shit to go on top.
Right.
Maybe I can put like Montana be the one that we pull up and they start checking bags, she gonna be like, making it all noticeable that we trying to sneak shit in.
No.
Yes, you do.
No, they're gonna be like,
why are you checking?
They're like,
I'm glad that shit smell good, don't it? Literally 8 minutes till the movie starts.
I know.
And we're at home.
Y'all go put in the comments right now if y'all think we gonna make it or not. 3 minutes. But we got credits.
Yeah, we got credits, so.
All right, should I take you out tonight or should you take me out?
I'll take you out.
I don't think so. I think I'm gonna take you out.
You're stupid. So Ryan already made up like 3 minutes. So we should make it. Have you been seeing all the TikToks on this movie?
Am I supposed to have?
It's supposed to be like the best rom-com.
I don't even know what a rom-com is. Oh.
Romantic comedy. But Sydney Sweeney's in it.
I don't know who that is.
Like, she's one of the girls from Euphoria. We didn't watch it.
But I couldn't tell you.
Apparently, she's... No shirt.
She got t- up. We ain't gonna see no dick, right?
No. Not. I don't think in this movie, no.
You but set me up, bro?
No!
Hold on, you set me up, actually.
No, I'm not. I'm dead serious. No play, I don't bro. Know if there's anything like that. No All play. I know I is that you can see, like... A little bit of her.
You set me up. I'm leaving.
Ryan. Yo, that's why Ryan doesn't want to watch Euphoria. Because he was like, he found out that there was like, if they're real or fake, I really don't know. But that there was, you know, guys. So he never wanted to watch Euphoria.
Does she look suspicious? Chill. You gonna be doing that watch.
This is what Ryan thinks I am. What do you think I look like?
Yeah, you be chicken shit. You be getting scary.
Can I get some popcorn too, please? Thanks. I love you.
I love you.
Ryan, come on. No, we grab pretzels. We can grab pretzels for real.
Week. Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
All right, fuck it. We'll grab pretzels.
You want a hot dog?
Yeah, they got the glizzy and the... You ever had that?
No.
That shit's good.
You're weird, though. You like stuff like that. Like, you like hot dogs.
Bruh, pause. Bruh.
Man, the glizzy.
You're eating like me.
Not funny.
And I guess just the regular salt pretzels. You want the long one?
I don't need the change.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Why you get all shy?
Yo. I'm shy.
You like the meatball.
You like the meatball.
Here, put this. Here, you got this shit sticking out here.
Come here.
16.
Thank you.
Damn, this movie theater is massive.
Wait, this is weird.
The camera on?
Yeah.
You can't film it here?
Definitely not.
Yeah, I know.
I was gonna set up and record the whole movie.
Ryan.
I'll mess with you, bro.
Maybe.
Is this the right one?
Yes, it's
right. Join your savings, rewards, and exclusive benefits. If you're...
Just go for it. Be confident.
I was actually kind of nervous because they were.
We come to AMC. It was a lot.
Peppermint tea, two sugars.
Thank you.
When your book begins, the rest is still unwritten.
Here's Ryan's favorite part.
Only you can let it.
What a cutie little date night.
I actually really like that movie. I love like romance movies, but that one was good. Like rom-coms are probably my favorite because like romance, but funny. And it was actually funny too because like sometimes like romance movies like can
funny.
Miss with the comedy, but it was actually funny. Now.
We should test to see if we're like, see our story. You know how they had a story?
Yeah.
Oh, she wants to come up.
What's up?
What's up, girly girl? What's up, girly girl?
Come on, big buddy. You're allowed up here, too.
Come on, up. Up, Kyo. Come on, up.
Good boy.
Daddy, be nice. Don't bite your
breath. Hey, be nice.
Don't bite your breath.
No bite, because he's going to bite back. And he's going to take your head off.
So it's actually the next night because there's a reason. Because we had to give what we're about to do a little bit more time. And by the time that we got back, it was so late. So we're basically going to put our questions in our relationship and all that to the test. Kind of like a...
Old wives' tale? It's kind of like an old wives' tale, but not.
But it's up to professionals.
Like it goes based off of like stars and the alignment of birthday and timing of when you were born and being together and when we met. So there's a lot more to it.
We're going to be talking to you guys about the Yoda app because we've used them before and we thought it was really cool. They have over 200 plus professional certified astrologers. Their app is user friendly. It's so easy to use. You just download it, you put in your information, and once you get into the app, you can ask them any questions that you want. They actually give you suggested questions. If you don't really know what to ask, they kind of put things into categories for you, which I feel like it's really cool. Honestly, we just had a lot of questions about what's gonna happen this year and things that we want to happen, or we just kind of want to know. And obviously you guys can ask whatever questions you're really thinking of about your life, about your career, your relationship, your financial situation, your future family, your health, your... And they literally have everything.
Hey, it really could help like somebody that's single and like wanting to know when they're gonna meet their person, because it might give some advice of like letting it happen or whatever they end up saying. You know, professionals are saying this, so it's like, I'm just gonna be honest though, last time we used Yoda, they hit straight on. I'll just give an example of one thing, but they said last year that they were just saying like
stuff,
we were gonna spend a lot of money, and then later in the year like you'll be able to like really settle down and be chill and it won't be a lot. And that's pretty, they hit that shit spot on. Because it was like money. I feel like all because of the wedding. This is how a wedding goes. But like, bro, they hit that spot on. So I thought that was crazy.
But Yoda is the top astrology app. It's honestly so cool to use. And one thing that I find really cool is that when you message them, their response time is literally between, like, for experience, our time is 10 minutes to like an hour. They're really on top of it and they're so thorough with how they respond to everything.
I asked them, will it rain on our wedding day?
What did it say?
It seems that rain is expected on your wedding day.
Oh my god, and it did. It did in the morning.
It did all the way up until 12 o'clock, right when we got to the venue, it stopped. Remember, it was like a bad storm in the morning.
Wait, that's crazy.
There might be some issues in your conjugal life, but the two of you shall solve them together and mutual consent and compromises. There will be a good change in your marital bond in September of 2023. That was right after the honeymoon.
Mm-hmm.
And remember we said we felt different?
Yeah.
See, it says the planets move and change their positions. Here's the horoscope update.
Basically, this is finding out when I'm going to be pregnant. Okay, basically what I asked,
I don't know. This is scary to ask, bro.
I know. My stomach hurts. I basically asked, will I get pregnant this year? I was, like, specific. But I said, what?
I asked that.
You did?
I said my wife and I are wanting to know when we will get pregnant. I forgot I asked that.
Wait, and then I said, what is 2024?
Wait, let's see if ours line up.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, okay. Okay, so he asked for, like, your information, like, where you were born, like, what time, what day, when you got married, all that. Dear Montana, kind regards, the in-depth study of your natal chart in comparison of your partner's chart shows that you are under the grace of the Sun and Mercury while he shares a blissful Venus and Jupiter favoring you guys to have a healthy and happy family life. Okay. You have positive prospects to experience the happiness of a newborn and parenthood in the coming future. No, I'm gonna start crying. Wait.
Keep reading.
Wait.
Keep reading! Stop! Don't do that!
No, wait. Okay. As per the readings, the ideal time for you to conceive your child this year shall be September 2024.
I just have the chills.
Shall
I just got the fucking chills.
As Venus shall be blessing you as well. Should you conceive around this time frame,
did we just find out that we're pregnant?
Able to have a healthy pregnancy and give birth to a healthy adult. Oh my god, really? Wait, this is weird. Wait, this is weird.
What does it say?
Wait, Ryan! I wasn't ready for this. If you conceive around this time frame, you shall be able to have a healthy pregnancy and give birth to a healthy and adorable baby girl who will resemble your personality and traits. Oh my god. Additionally, you are advised to prioritize your physical and psychological well-being during your pregnancy such that you keep your health safe and your baby protected. Okay, can you read yours?
I'm scared to read this. Analyzing your natal chart with considering details from your partner's natal chart, you guys have a favorable alignment of the Sun, Venus, and Jupiter, supporting an adorable child with enjoying parenthood in the coming time. A new arrival of this child shall bring even more happiness and good fortune to your family. However, some resistance from the North Lunar Node, as seen in your wife's natal chart, might bring health complications during the time of pregnancy. Doing yoga and meditation. I don't need to read this.
Why?
I'm here now. Doing yoga and meditation for at least 20 minutes daily and taking nutritious diet shall help her to maintain her health in good condition.
That's what they told me.
Moving ahead with positive mindsets and following proper consultation with a doctor shall lead you to a smooth pregnancy this time. It says February 2026.
It said that last time.
Did it?
Yeah. Yeah, but mine said different.
if it takes a little longer.
Yeah,
it's
right.
It's saying conceive February 2026.
Yeah.
Conceiving a child shall give birth to a healthy and cute baby girl.
Oh my gosh.
Yo, that's fucking insane. That's crazy. I asked how our 2024 is going to look like because we kind of know what it's going to look like, I feel like, already.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You guys have a favorable alignment of the Sun, Venus, and Jupiter, supporting an adorable child with enjoying parenthood in coming time. I didn't even ask about pregnancy, bro.
That's what I'm saying.
This is the second question. This has nothing to do with the first question. Yo, that's scary. That's freaking scary. Oh. What the freak? A new arrival of this child shall bring even more happiness and good fortune to your family. From January, they're so specific, bro. They said from January till May, both of you shall be in a good state of mind under the alignment of Mercury. Get betterment in your career, get better opportunity to complete your pending desire to see happy family life.
Relax. Just keep reading.
It says you're going to spend most of your spare time with your wife and will bring you happiness and joy into your life.
Yeah,
I know.
You have a best friend.
That's funny because me and Montana has said that we want to spend more really, really good quality time together and really focus on us this year.
Wow.
However, some resistance from the North Lunar Node might bring temporary issues regarding your health and personal life from June to July, which you have to remain cautious about. We don't know time frame, but fuck. You are advised to take care of your health and try to seek medical attention if needed. I just find it crazy that they are talking about, they even know about health. We didn't say your health things or nothing. Like, we didn't talk about the tumor. We didn't talk about, like, nothing. We just asked. We didn't ask, like, are we going to have good health? We didn't ask none of that. They just jumped straight to it. That's what I find crazy.
If not September, December, right?
Both of you shall get the opportunity to travel new places, which will bring you a memorable moment in your life. And then it says, wishing you a happy family life ahead. They're very in detail. Honestly, gives us like a different perspective and kind of more in depth of something to look forward to. This good energy is put in the air. So let's like just like take it all in. So since Ryan and I are subscribed, when we ask questions, it actually gives us like more questions to ask for free. But if you guys use our link down in the description, you guys get a free question. So obviously we asked more. So if you want more than just one free question, you guys can subscribe because I feel like it's really cool.
We're gonna look back on this at the end of the year and be like,
I know.
I don't know, I have a feeling.
You know, there's a lot of health things that we're going to be talking about soon that has to do with me. This first half of the year is going to be really, really dedicated to getting my health right, getting our foundations healthy. But make sure you guys check out the description for more information about Yoda. You can download the app and use our link. But we love you guys so much. Thanks for hanging out with us, going on a date night, and kind of finding out more info on our future family. But we'll see you guys next video. Merc Workout. Peace.